smash.
12-5.
We saw that he was committed to the backhand defence. Yeah, hitting down his forehand side. Perfect placement. Around the back. Spectacular, but rarely gains any advantage.
6-12.
Making your opponents play one more shot. So that's his fastest of the match so far.
Serve, serve them. 13-6.
Better rally. Oh, without doubt, the longest rally of the match so far.
Serve, serve.
Without doubt, the best rally of the match so far.
14-8.
Yeah. Well, it does allow opponents back into matches.
15-10.
Oh, that's a lovely play from Coop. Smash. Oh, terrific
17,
angle. Terrific placement.
10.
And we're up for 62 miles an hour.
18-10.
3 points needed for a third semi-final appearance here at the Indonesia Open.
11-18.
judgment.
Serve, serve up. 19, 11. Serve, serve up. 12, 19.
Oh. No. 13,
19.
Keep anticipating one way. Opponents currently hitting it the other.
14, 19.
Half the 8-point deficit. Now it's down to 4 points.
Serve is over. 20.
5 match point opportunities.
15.
Kim Kiat can turn Boon Hyun.
Game.
Yeah, comprehensive in the end. 21-11, 21-15, in just 25 minutes. And that means that Kuintan.
Match won by Kuintan Kiat.
Matthias Bell, Carsten Mogensen.
21-11, 21-15.
All matches of the quarterfinals today on the field. See you tomorrow at 11:30 for the semifinals. Thank you.
Center stage, there's confirmation. 4 different nations represented at semi-final stage in the men's doubles, as indeed with the men's singles tomorrow. Well, as the men's doubles quarterfinals conclude, opportunity for us just to recap on what's happened today on quarterfinals day. And it all started with an all-Indonesian men's singles in Simon Santoso, the number 7 seed, overcoming his teammate Dionysius Hayam Orumbaka. Before we recap on all matches, just an opportunity to see some of the highlights from that men's doubles. So, just to recap on everything that's happened on quarterfinals day, Simon Santoso, the number 7 seed, beating his teammate Orumbaka in 2 straight games. And then a big upset in the women's doubles, the home players Johari and Polly overcoming the number 8 seeds Maeda and Suetsuna, their first ever victory over that Japanese pair. Then it was men's doubles, the number 2 seeds of Lee Yong-dae and Jung Jae-sung. Straight game victory against the Malaysians Hoon and Tan. And then it was one match too many as far as Sonny Dwi Kunchioro was concerned. His 11th match in 10 days of badminton, having won last week in Thailand. Just didn't have enough to give against Du Peng Yu, who fought every rally right to the bitter end. Then it was mixed doubles, and my goodness, the beaten finalists from last year, Tantowi Ahmad and Liliana Natsir, pushed the full distance by the brother and sister combination, Kido and Bernadette. Then, of course, we went on to more men's doubles and the European champions, Matthias Bo and Carsten Mogensen, keeping their run of matches and victories going over Chai Biao and Guo Zhengdong. That's four in a row now that they won out of four encounters. But that women's singles, Simon Awol, who had three match points in that second game, lost it before coming back in the third, 21-19. That was a match to remember and a match to savor, an hour and 36 minutes. And then, as we've just witnessed, men's doubles, Ku and Tan, comprehensive victory for the number eight seeds, 21-11, 21-15, and they're through to meet Bo and Mogensen in the semi-finals. Well, talking of semi-finals, that's going to happen tomorrow. We'll be a little bit later with semi-final action tomorrow. That's 14:30 local time.